So welcome back, dear students. Today let us have example of COF6 3-. This is the compound will be given to you, and they will be asking you to find out the shape, hybridization, and geometry of particular this molecule. So all the 3D series elements must be by heart for you all. So when you consider 3D series, it starts from scandium. So scandium 21, titanium 22, vanadium 23, chromium 24, manganese 25, iron 26, cobalt 27, nickel 28, and copper 29. Lastly, we have zinc 30. So these are said to be 3D series in which we are interested in cobalt because it is our transition metal present here. So when you consider cobalt, what will be the electronic configuration we will be writing here? See, argon, it will be argon, okay, 3d7, 4s2 electrons are present in this cobalt. Okay, so we need to know atomic number first. Once we confirm the atomic number, we need to understand how to write the electronic configuration. And here we all know chromium and copper are said to be exception, because there will be a half filled as well as completely filled electrons are coming. I'll be explaining these things when we start with the D and F block elements. Till then, just have a knowledge of these 3D series and try to know the how we supposed to write the electronic configuration. So argon 3d7 4s2 we have. Here in this case, we need to check out the particularly oxidation state for cobalt. Let me rub this one. So when you consider cobalt here, it is X we can consider plus 6. Totally it is given minus 3. So X is plus 3. Cobalt is in plus 3 oxidation state. If it is plus 3 oxidation state, we need to remove 3 electrons from this one. Then it will be, when cobalt is plus 3 oxidation state, we need to remove 3 electrons. It will become 3d6. Need to understand that 3d6 electrons must be arranged here. How to arrange these electrons? Let us consider 3d orbital here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, it is 3d orbital present here. Like that, we also have 4s orbital. We also have 4p orbital also. Okay, 3d. 4s we will be having, let us not consider this one right now. I explain you some things, then I will tell you. Now we have halogen. Fluorine is the halogen. Halogens are weak filled ligands. Halogens are weak filled ligands. When you consider weak filled ligands, what happens? Pairing doesn't take place. Rather, they will move to the next energy shells or next orbitals. Electrons movement is going to take place. Here, 3d6 is there. In the sense, we need to fill all the 6 electrons in 3d. So, how to fill that one? Each 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is 6th electron we have filled here. As we have weak filled ligand here, due to presence of this weak filled ligand, pairing of these electrons does not take place. Rather, next electrons which are involved here, or the next orbitals which are empty here, there exactly addition of F6 electrons will be settled. Okay, once we have 4s, we have 4p. I'll let you know the things here. We have 4p, then we also have 4d. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We have 4d. Now we need to provide certain space to occupy all the 6 electrons, 6 pair electrons of fluorine. They will be coming here. As I told you, fluorine is weak filled ligand. Pairing does not take place. In the sense, 3d orbital doesn't involve in hybridization. Rather, s, p and d orbitals are involved. Here, this d orbital, which is coming after the 3d, is considered as outer d orbital, and the whole complex is going to be referred as outer orbital complex. So now see here, we are making use of s. This is p and d orbitals. How many fluorine are coming? There are 6 fluorine are coming. So you can see here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay, one fluorine comes and gives its electrons to s, and second comes here, gives electrons to p, then it gives here. Okay, like this addition of electrons or hybridization is going to take place between transition metal and the approaching ligands. So once it's done, here you could say that s orbital and 2 of the d orbitals are involved in the hybridization. So with respect to this one, we can say that what is the hybridization? sp3, s orbital is involved, p3 orbitals are involved, and we have 2 d orbitals are involved here. Okay, so what is the hybridization? It is sp3d2 hybridization with respect to this example. And as I told you, halogens are said to be weak field ligands. There is no pairing has occurred, rather these ligands are moved to the next orbitals. So such compounds are said to be paramagnetic in nature. Paramagnetic in nature, these are said to be paramagnetic compounds. And as there is a usage of outer d orbital as is involved in the hybridization process, this whole complex is said to be outer orbital complex. It is said to be outer orbital complex. And as there are 6 orbitals are involved, there are 2 + 3, 5 + 1. It is said to be octahedral complex. Shape of the molecule is octahedral. This is said to be octahedral complex. At the last of the solving these problems, at last you need to write these simple points, so that you definitely are going to get all the 3 marks stipulated for this question. So like this, we will have other examples also. Please do copy this. We'll move to the next. Can you see this example, dear students? NiCl4 2-. So when you consider NiCl4 2-, we need to know that nickel is with 3d8 4s2. I have shown you, we need to remember the atomic number for the transition metals of 3d series, and 3d8 4s2 is the configuration for nickel. But in this state, example, nickel is present in +2 oxidation state. So when you consider 3D, we need to fill up all the 8 electrons in this fashion. Later, we need to fill up 4 Cl, that is halogen ligands in a next orbitals. This is 3D, this is 4S, next we have 4P present over here. As halogen is approaching to the central metal atom, is considered as weak field ligand. Halogen is considered as weak field ligand. You just remember, all the halogens are said to be weak field ligands, that is pairing of the electrons does not take place. Whereas ammonia, that is NH3, CN or R, referred as a strong field ligands, pairing of the electrons takes place. You need to remember this much. And the explanation regarding this point I will give you when we start with the crystal field theory. Okay, now see here, 3d8 8 electrons I have filled. I left with 4 Cl. So each Cl will come with pair of electrons. Cl, 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 and this Cl comes and it gives here. Okay, this is here, this is here, and this is here. You can see that there are s orbital and p orbitals are involved in the hybridization. There is 1s, 3p orbitals are involved in the hybridization process. And it can be shown like this fashion. This is hybridization denotation. So there are 4 Cl, each will provide 2 electrons. Okay, like this they will be approaching. And with this concept, we can say that this whole complex is of sp3 hybridization. sp3 hybridization. So whenever a complex present in sp3 hybridization, we can say that it is tetrahedral geometry. Okay, then we can say that here only s and p orbitals are involved in this case, and sp3 is the hybridization, tetrahedral will be the shape of this molecule, and as weak field ligands are approaching, it is said to be paramagnetic complex. It is said to be paramagnetic complex. And when you see the structure, it will be Cl like this. This is Cl, this is Cl, this is. This is said to be tetrahedral structure for this complex. Understood? So like this we will do next also. Please do copy this. We will move to the next. Let us check with respect to this example, NiCl4 2-. So once again I'll begin with the first. So when you consider the oxidation state for the nickel, Ni nickel oxidation state, you need to find out X, okay, plus Cn, each Cn possesses -4. This is 2, and whole charge on this one, it is given as -2. Okay, X minus 4 you will be getting equal to -2, in the sense X will be +2 oxidation state. Nickel is present in +2 oxidation state in this case. Okay, now we have nickel configuration is 3d8 4s2. fine, as nickel is present in +2 oxidation state, we need to consider as 3d8. Only 8 electrons must be filled in the orbitals. Then Cn is approaching as a ligand here. Cn is considered as a strong field ligand. Whenever strong field ligands are approaching to the central metal atom, there will be a pairing of the electrons that takes place. When pairing of the electrons takes place, I told you the complex will be showing a diamagnetic property. Okay, I'll tell you one by one with the explanation. See here. So oxidation state we have formed. Now we need to arrange these electrons. That is 3d8 electrons. Now it will become 4s0 here. Okay, let us fill all the 8 electrons in it. Nickel, 3d8 electrons. Now let me consider Dr. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, here 3d8 electrons I have to fill. So it is 3d. Fine. Then I have 3d, 4s. Okay, then I have 4p. Here, what pairing of the electrons is going to take place? Strong field ligand is approaching. Pairing of electrons takes place. As pairing takes place, compound will be diamagnetic. Pairing of electrons takes place. Now you can see here, 8 electrons I have to fill. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 electrons are paired. Now, this also get paired with the in one of the unpaired electrons. Now you can say that this D, okay, and this S as well as this P orbitals are going to be involved in the hybridization process. I repeat my words, pairing of this electron takes place within the D subshell. Then S orbital as well as P orbital is going to be involved in hybridization. Now we can say that one S orbital is involved. 2, 4, 6, 8. Yes. S orbital is 1 is involved. 3 p orbitals are involved. Now we need to understand how does hybridization takes place. As there are 4 cn are present, I must have to write here cn. There are 4 cn approaching. 1, 2, 3. Okay. This is 4th cn is approaching. And here after the rearrangement, how does it looks like? See, this is 1d orbital which is left here. Then I have s orbital which is left from here. And I have, so 2 are completely occupied by 2. Out of these 3, I make use of only 2. Innansa ta helthe nodri, correct agi kelisukori. Namkade 3d olaga 8 electrons adavu. Ee 8 electron anna 3d subshell olaga navu fill madatheevi. Heng fill madidvi? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and the fill according to Hooke's principle. It is done. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ನಮಗೆ ಏನಿದಿಲ್ಲೇ 4s ಆರ್ಬಿಟಲ್ ಐತಿ ಈ ಕಡೆ 4p ಆರ್ಬಿಟಲ್ ಐತಿ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಲಿಗಂಡ್ ಅಪ್ರೋಚ್ ಆಗೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಏನಾಗ್ತೈತಿ ಸ್ಪ್ಲಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಈ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್ ಲಿಗಂಡ್ಸ್ ಮೈಮೆಲ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್ ಸ್ಪ್ಲಿಟ್ ಆಗೋದು ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇರ್ತೈತಿ ಸ್ಪ್ಲಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಈ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಮೇಲ್ಗಡೆ ಜಂಪ್ ಮಾಡಕ ಆಗಂಗಿಲ್ಲ ಮೇಲ್ಗಡೆ ಜಂಪ್ ಮಾಡೋದ್ರ ಬದಲಿ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾವು ಅಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲೆ ಅರೇಂಜ್ ಆಗ್ಬಿಡ್ತಾವು सो एलेक्ट्रॉन अरेंज आगत इलागत ओके एलेक्ट्रॉन अरेंज आदमे एम टी उल्ती अदा इकोनि नेक्स्ट 4s ऑर्बिटल ऐतल इू कूड़ा एम टी ऑलरेडी इतनी अदान इकोनि 4p एर अस्टर बे नम या टोटल नाक अस्ट लिगंड अदाव सी एन फोर टोटल नाक लिगंड अदाव इगर इकोनि दिस इज एम टी वी नीड टू लीव दिस वन आई मस्ट हैव टू शो हियर ओके Once we done this one, see one ligand is approaching, second is approaching, third is approaching, and fourth is approaching. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 electrons. DSP2 is the hybridization. What is the hybridization for this molecule? It is DSP2 hybridization. Whenever we have DSP2 hybridization, complex will be square planar. square planar and here inner d orbitals are involving in the hybridization this is called as inner orbital complex this is said to be inner orbital complex right so dsp2 hybridization square planar it is said to be inner orbital complex magnetic property as sharing is occurring here it is said to be what diamagnetic complex last point this is first point you have to write second point third point fourth point you have to write it is said to be what diamagnetic complex it is said to be diamagnetic complex okay when you go for the structure of this one NiCN4 square planar NiCN this is said to be the structure for this complex square planar is the structure if you write this much definitely you are going to obtain 3 marks